Alright, now it's time for some Dio once again. I've reacted to Heaven and Hell quite a while ago, honestly. That was when he was with Black Sabbath. And then his two biggest hits, I'd say, or at least I think, Rainbow in the Dark, and then, of course, Holy Diver. And I've loved them all. I love Dio. I love him in Pick of Destiny as well. Tenacious D, the Pick of Destiny. Awesome movie. Hilarious. But one song I always see on YouTube, I always see tons of reactions for it. I always see people just loving it and just, like, dying for it. That song is Stargazer by Rainbow, and obviously this is, I think, Dio's band before he joined Black Sabbath and then before he did his own solo career. And the song is 8 minutes and 25 seconds or something around there. And then I also checked the studio one because I think this is live. I just clicked on the first video, but the studio version is also as long because I did check just to make sure, because that one performance of Heaven and Hell live is amazing, but it's like 3 or 4 minutes longer than the actual studio version. But I'm excited because Dio obviously has one of the greatest voices of all time, and I mean, it's just like the operatic voice, the rock, the rasp, everything about it is perfect. I'm excited. I don't know what this will sound like. I don't know if this will be some big ballad or whatever it'll be, but the song is 8 minutes and 25 seconds, so I assume it will be. That's an awesome, awesome album cover. I assume this is studio. Wow. Oh my god, he's unbelievable. It reminds me of an outfit that Ozzy wore. Oh, don't give me an ad, you mother. Whatever that company was, you just interrupted Dio. I hate you. Anyway, 112. Love the drums here, too. And then, of course, his voice. This video edited so 70s. Oh my god. If only I could sing like him. My god. Desert. Yeah. So awesome. Wow. Just makes me smile, man. God. And he's playing the drum like a, like a jazz drummer, I think. Is that the best way to describe it? Whatever. Or his hands turn the other way instead of both like this. Wow. My volume's turned up so I can barely hear myself talking, but wow. using slide guitar. Okay. Or playing slide guitar. Whoa. Wow. Fast guitar playing will always impress me. I don't care. I love the drums too. It's just like the crashes. I love that. Oh, don't give me another ad. This never happens. I don't care, Ray and the Last Dragon. He's having fun. Oh wow, it's like some Rage Against the Machine stuff, up really high. All eyes see the figure of the wizard as he climbs. The wizard walks by. No sound as he falls instead of rising. Time standing still, then there's blood on the sand. Oh, I see. Wow. Unbelievable. Like, I already know the boom, 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 boom. I love that. Everybody's going like this. I love this so much. Really cool, like, performance-wise, too. I know it's, like, studio, but still. Some Kurt Cobain shit. So grand! This is so awesome. Classic fade out, you know. Don't give me another ad. This shows me that I'm never gonna go to YouTube. I'm gonna download it first and then watch it from there. That was so awesome. That's already one of my favorite rock ballads ever. Besides the stupid ads interrupting me, and now I just... I'm never gonna straight up just watch it on YouTube right away. I'm gonna download it, then watch it, which I have done in the past, but it can be glitchy at times. But anyway, Oh my God. Like, I know I talked over sometimes when he was singing, but I always say this. I don't know if people believe me, but my volume is louder than me speaking to the point where I can always hear whatever, like the music over my voice. Like, my brain focuses on the music, if that makes sense. But this was awesome. It seemed like it was telling the story almost of like some character. I'm assuming some like magical character, maybe like a wizard or something, because there was that line that had something about a wizard, and then I referenced The Wizard by Black Sabbath because, you know, it's a great song, and, you know, we're talking about Dio here, and Dio was obviously in Black Sabbath. So this is really cool, and this was 1976. Okay, I really didn't know anything going into it besides that it was a band with Dio in it before he was in Black Sabbath and before his own solo career, which I need to listen to more of. I'm gonna react to more of that. And tonight, actually, after I finish this video, I'm probably going to listen to that full Holy Diver album just because I'm done with the reactions for the songs for that album, but I still got more from other albums. But anyway, let's talk about what the song really means or see if I was right. The lyrics taken literally are about a wizard who enslaves countless numbers of people and makes them build a stone tower for him. Okay, yeah, there are lots of lines like that. The people hope for a day when the misery comes to the end as they build their tower in harsh conditions in the heat and rain with whips and chains, as he likes to sing. I don't know if it exactly sounded like that, something like that. Just so they can see him fly, which gives them hope. In the end, the wizard falls off the tower and dies. No sound as he's falling instead of rising. Time stands still, and there's blood on the sand. The lyrics also have a covert meaning, which many people have interpreted as a warning to not believe in false idols or messiahs. It can also mean that one should not give up hope, even in harsh circumstances. The song is quite a production. It runs 8 minutes and 26 seconds. It features the Munich Philharmonic Orchestration. The song also showcases Ronnie James Dio's soaring vocals and Ritchie Blackmore's guitar work. Yes, amazing. And it kind of blew my mind in a way. I know I didn't give the biggest reaction just because I don't know, like, I don't want to get too into it, but kind of feeling a bit weird right now. But I needed a really great song to kind of bring me up, and this one did in a way. Like, it touched me in a way. I feel like I was told this great story, and I mean, apparently it was, because it is kind of told about this wizard who does some bad stuff and then dies at the end, and is really grand. It's just one of the most grand songs out there. I think it's just unbelievable. Dio is just one of the best to ever do it, and I think he has one of the best voices ever. Like, I'm talking top five of all time, especially for rock. I'm really interested. I know that even though this song is 8 minutes and 26 seconds, I'm gonna listen to it a million times, honestly, and get all the words down in my head, because I always do that. And are there any other songs by Rainbow that you want to see me react to? Because I do plan to react to more from Dio's solo career, just because I know it has some great ones. Well, it has a bunch of great ones. I've heard he's one of the best metal artists, but this one really was great. I am kind of in shock. I don't fully know what to say, but what do you think of the song? Please tell me in the comments down below. What's your favorite Dio song? And thank you all for watching. See you guys next time. Over and out.